The president's about to give his big State of the Union address, and all day we were reminded of the strategies behind every move in that room, the handshakes, the seating arrangements, and the unscripted moments. ABC's John Donvan looks at what's happening behind the picture we see.
The president of the United States.
You want to think that pomp and ceremony like this is set in stone in the Constitution or someplace, but actually, there's always been a fair amount of tweaking and improv going on. Like, look here, last year's speech, the guy shaking the president's hand, year before that, same guy. More than 10 years before, same guy. 24 years before, same guy. New York's Elliot Engel, who always gets there hours ahead of time. This afternoon, he had a space marked out already for tonight, but he risked stepping outside to tell us why he has to do this now.
Now people are so used to seeing me, I think if I didn't show up, they'd think I was sick or something.
Other kinds of tweaks and improv. Well, there's that whole point to the heroes in the high seats thing, year after year. But it only started in 1982, when a man named Lenny Skutnik improvised a rescue in real life. A Ronald Reagan speechwriter tweaked his speech, and it put Lenny in that chair. Audience improv. Well, there was the time President Obama tweaked the Supreme Court on a decision about campaign financing, and Justice Alito retweaked, not true. That wasn't in the script. But then neither is Elliot Engel, who's always there, a fixture overlooked by the Constitution, but definitely part of the ceremony. John Donvan, ABC News, Washington.